Speaking of that, Edward Snowden's statement, he says, I acted on my belief that the NSA's mass surveillance programs would not withstand a constitutional challenge and that the American public deserved a chance to see these issues determined by open courts. Today, a secret program authored by that secret court was, when exposed to the light of day, found to violate Americans' rights. It's the first of many, Charles.
Look, let's not jump ahead of ourselves. It isn't as if he made yet a constitutional ruling. He issued an injunction against the collection of the data, but then he stayed the injunction so that the administration, the government, has an opportunity to present a case because national security here is at stake. So he said if the issue came to him, as it will in time, he is inclined to rule that it's unconstitutional, but it's not a ruling yet. Second, he's only one judge. We have no idea how this would end up in the Supreme Court. It's the beginning of a process. Third, the administration and the previous one had acted under the last Supreme Court ruling on this issue, the Smith case of 1979, in which it said there is no reasonable expectation of privacy in the case of the metadata on phones. So it was acting within the current understanding of the Constitution. What Leon is arguing is that the use of the phone, the way that this information is more detailed today, is different than it was in the 70s, and thus it's in the invasion of the Fourth Amendment. But that issue is as yet undetermined, and there is no definitive ruling yet. So it isn't as if Snowden is vindicated. He's not exactly a constitutional lawyer. And if he was interested in this, he would have leaked only this instead of taken everything that he has into Russia and China and kept it from the authorities.
That's an important point. Judge Leon's ruling is stayed right now, pending appeal.